And now we will learn the most advanced level of recording QuickBooks transactions, owner's equity, and co-mingling funds. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Owners normally give and take money to and from their business. Sometimes they give or take cash, but sometimes they give or take other non-cash assets. Sometimes they co-mingle funds, and this means paying business expenses from personal funds or paying personal expenses with business funds. Owner's equity transactions require that we have two specific accounts in our chart of accounts to be able to properly record transactions where assets come to or from the owner. First, we have to put in the chart of accounts an account called Owner's Capital Investment. This is an account that represents the total money or asset value that the owner gave to the business. The other account we have to put in the chart of accounts is called Owner's Withdrawals, and this represents the total money or asset value that the owner took out of the business. So let's go ahead and record these and put them in our chart of accounts. And when we put them in the chart of accounts, remember the owner's name is Vonda. So let's put her name with the name of the accounts. We open the chart of accounts by scrolling down and click Accounting, Chart of Accounts. And we all remember to put a new account, we click New. Now, obviously the account type is equity because that's the topic of this video. But the detail type has several suggestions, most of which you would study about in an accounting course. But the closest detail type that you could choose in this example would be partner contributions. And again, it often doesn't matter the detail type, and it probably wouldn't matter in this case. But as far as the description of what we will use the account for, it's better to choose the best detail type, partner contributions, and we'll put Vonda's capital. Then we're going to click Save and New. Now, the next one is also equity type, and the closest detail type would be the opposite, partner dispersions or distributions, because this will be Vonda's withdrawals. Click Save and Close, and now we have the accounts in the chart of accounts that we would need if the owner gives to or takes from cash or any asset to or from Vonda's business. Now, the simplest example of how to use these accounts is when the owner gives or takes cash to or from the company bank account. In a case like that, you would just make those transactions in the windows that you would normally use. For example, let's imagine on May 18, Vonda wrote check number 1776 for $1,000 from her personal non-business account and then deposited that money into our cash and bank business account specifically for that money to be used for business expenses. Well, Vonda's capital is going to show up in the trial balance for the very first time as $1,000 because this is the first time we are recording money or any asset coming from the owner to the business. What other account will change? Well, cash in bank will become this number. In other words, cash in bank right now is $30,552. But if the owner puts an additional $1,000 into the cash in bank, it'll be $31,552. And of course, Vonda's capital will be $1,000. And it's very easy to do that. If we're depositing money into our bank account, we simply use the Make Deposit window. We click the plus sign for a new transaction, and we go over to Bank Deposit. Now, the date that we're making this deposit is supposed to be May 18 of 2017. Okay, now ignore what's sitting in undeposited funds. That's for later. Don't worry about that. But we received money from the owner. Now the owner is not on the list, and we could either add the owner or, you know, add the owner as a vendor or a customer, or we could leave it blank. I'm going to leave it blank, but what we cannot leave blank is the reason for the deposit. Why did the bank account go up? The bank account went up because the owner invested money from their personal funds. And that account that represents that is Vonda's capital. And the amount that she gave us is $1,000. Okay, now when we click save and close, we look at the trial balance and the numbers are exactly what we expected. Cash in bank has increased to $31,552, and for the very first time, Vonda's capital shows up on the trial balance as a credit of $1,000. Now let's try the opposite. Let's imagine on May 19, Vonda wrote check number 903 for $500 from the cash in bank business account to her son's dentist to be used for non-business personal reasons. Well, that's very easy. All we have to do is go to the checks window, put in the date May 19th, and it's paid to the order of, again, we are allowed to leave it blank, or you could add the owner's name as a customer or a vendor. But what we must do is make sure we record the check number. Obviously, someone spilled coffee on 902, so we're using 903. And the category, which means the account and the chart of accounts, would be Vonda's withdrawals. Vonda's withdrawals. Remember, this is the account that represents the money or asset value that the owner took out of the business. And in this case, she's taking out $500. Now, before we save this, can we predict what the results will be? Well, if this is the first time we're recording an owner's withdrawal, that means that withdrawals will show up for the first time as $500. And of course, the bank account will decrease by $500 and become $31,052.20. Let's see if that works. We click save and close, and we look at the trial balance. $31,052.20 is the result in the bank account. And as you can see on the debit side, for $500, Vonda's withdrawals showed up for the very first time.